Hey guys, this week we're going to be breaking down how to make a successful Kickstarter video. The video is going to be your best opportunity to communicate your product effectively and tell your story. So what we want to do today is break down our video piece by piece, and hopefully this might act as a template or a framework for making your own. All right, let's do this.
My name is Brian Chu. I am one of the founders of Hook Home.
My name is Connor Coughlin. I am the other founder of Hook Home.
And I'm Evan Bruce. I'm a designer of Hook Home.
So we can take you on a quick run through of our video, and we'll just describe what's going on.
So the most important thing with the video is the first 5 to 10 seconds of the video. So, you know, as much as people are very visual, they also have very short attention spans.
Yeah, so you gotta grab them immediately. So if you look at our video here, we're 10 seconds in. The first 3 or 4 seconds, you already know that it's a piece of furniture. You already know about the joint. You see how it's clicking together. And like, that was something that we worked super hard on. Mm-hmm. And you know, you just don't have time for setting the scene and context. You really got to get into it really quickly.
After the initial 10 seconds, what we did was we went back to how we developed the product, showing you all of our prototypes, showing you that it works. You know, all the thought process behind how we develop the product. And then we kind of show how the product is used in daily life. We set the scenes in, friends and family's apartments, using them in daily life. So you really get the sense of how our product works, how our product would look in your apartment, and how you would live with the product.
Yeah, and you know, what we did early on in one of the earlier scenes is we answered a question that we thought the consumer would have, was stability. So you could see that we packed up a bunch of cement bags and, you know, drums of paint on top of the furniture. So straight away, you know, this product is made out of recycled milk jugs. You know, the concern might be that it's not stable. Actually, it's quite the opposite. So we answered that question in the video, like, straight off the bat.
Here you can see us fabricating the pieces of furniture to show that it comes from our shop in Brooklyn. It's not outsourced anywhere. We are a vertically integrated shop, so anything that we design, we build here in Brooklyn.
Yeah, and so much of the video is kind of about the narrative of both our shop and the product and how they're kind of interwoven together.
Yeah, so then we showed it in multiple apartments just so, you know, you could really show the product and how we saw people using it at home. We kind of have a conversation with us back in the shop just to kind of put a face to the product and to the names. So there's a, you know, you're humanizing the product, and people want to get behind people. You know, it's not necessarily the product. They kind of want to see that there's, you know, passionate people behind this piece of furniture that we designed. Arguably, this is the most important thing that you can do to have a successful campaign.
It is the most important, for sure, because people are very visual. They want to see what your product is about. They want to see that it works.
Tell your story. I mean, Kickstarter is kind of established for smaller creators. So I think it lends to more of a familiar or like a jovial approach to filmmaking. So like, you're able to stylize the videos as long as they go in tandem with kind of like your idea for the product.
Yeah.
So it's not, it doesn't need to be polished. I feel like sometimes people are even scared of polished videos because it does seem
true.
Kickstarter is not really a corporate space, whereas like some of those videos are kind of out of place. So I would almost lean more into kind of like telling your story in your own way.
Right. Yeah. It's tell your story and describe the product correctly.
Mm-hmm.
Like
exactly.
those are the main things. Like, answer the questions that you think the consumer is going to have.
Yeah.
It took a number of weeks to film this video and edit it. Probably took about a month. But in the end, we kept it to about 3 minutes. And that, even that is a lot of time to keep someone's attention. But we had a whole furniture line to describe and to talk about, so we felt that was a good length of time for the video. But anywhere from like a minute to 3 minutes is probably suitable.
I guess an important aspect of the video is to show how your product is different, how your product stands out from other competition. So our product is made from 100% post-consumer recycled plastics, milk jugs, bottles, things like that. And the top is made from FSC certified plywood. So we try to emphasize that portion in our video to differentiate ourselves from the competition.
Mm-hmm.
When people think of recycled plastics, they might think, oh, it might look, very
cheap
or makeshift or very DIY. What we wanted to do was separate ourselves from that and show that we can make a very beautiful, elegant product with these sustainable materials.
I think it's important to finish the video off kind of establishing the clear goals of what the Kickstarter campaign
right.
is.
Right,
yeah. Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So there's no ambiguity to what...
Sure.
Because like, at the end of the day, you're asking for money, so it's not...
So ask them.
Yeah,
so,
yeah. Like, you don't need to, like, kind of, you know, dodge around the question. Like,
true.
It's just, don't be ashamed to ask for money when you're asking for money.
Yep, exactly.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. I hope that was a helpful video for you. If you know anybody that might be interested in this type of content, please share it with them. If you have more questions for us about the video, please leave them in the comment section below. And just to let you know, this is going to be part of a larger series where we kind of pick apart our Kickstarter campaign just to offer you guys lessons and advice if you're thinking about running your own. So we're going to dive into how we built our Kickstarter campaign page. And we're going to offer our top tips for the campaign in general. So definitely stay tuned, subscribe if you want to get those notifications for our new videos every Sunday morning. And thanks for watching.